What's good YouTube, it's Aeo here with a GBU match which I had about 3 weeks ago-ish when I was still using this team. I've actually moved on from this team, which is why I am kind of showing it you now, because originally this was going to be my VGC 12 team and I decided to kind of improve it a bit. So I've now obviously got a new team and this team's up for RMT, so if you want to go and check that out, you are perfectly welcome to. So anyway, to start off the match, I decided to go for a helping hand with Cresselia to boost Terrakion's close combat, which does a heck of a lot to Metagross, but unfortunately it doesn't actually KO it, which is kind of a bummer on my part, but it's not the end of the world. So anyway, he goes for a Thunderbolt, presumably trying to get a little bit of damage onto my Cresselia, and it's not going to do a great deal. And he finally goes for a Meteor Mash and gets the attack raise, which is really bad news on my part. It's not like it's the end of the world or anything, but if Cresselia does get hit by another Meteor Mash, I could be in some serious trouble. So anyway, I'm going to go for a helping hand with Cresselia to try and boost up Terrakion's next attack, and then Metagross actually goes for a Protect to make sure that I don't hit Metagross with like any kind of move, but I actually go for the Rock Slide rather than the close combat. Although it doesn't do anything to Metagross, it's like not really what I was aiming for. I was more aiming for the Zapdos. Charty Berry does weaken it, and he is able to get up the Tailwind, but again, doesn't really matter all too much. I got some damage on, which is what I wanted. So anyway, I go for a Protect with my Terrakion to preserve the Focus Sash, and Zapdos actually goes for a Heat Wave. Hopefully, I'm guessing he was trying to get rid of my Focus Sash on my Terrakion after the Bullet Punch with Metagross, and maybe burn one of my Pokemon. He does get the burn with Cresselia, but doesn't really matter at this point. Anyway, I twist the dimensions to counteract the fact that Tailwind's up, and Metagross is able to go for a Bullet Punch, which is kinda annoying, I guess, but my Terrakion's still gonna outspeed Zapdos at the least. So Terrakion's quite easily able to go for Close Combat or even Rock Slide, whichever one. I believe I go for the Close Combat onto... No, I actually go for the Rock Slide, my bad. And of course, Cresselia can wear down Zapdos with Ice Beam. So unfortunately, Rock Slide is never going to KO Metagross from that range since it's so bulky and has such high defense. And all it means now is that he can send out a Hitmontop, which has... I believe it has Technician on this one. Normally I see them with Intimidate, which kind of threw me a bit. Didn't really matter either way. And he can fake out my Cresselia, which means that it's going to die from burn damage, and then just use Bullet Punch with Metagross to get the Terrakion into fainted mood, if you wish. He did get a crit on the Terrakion, which, again, doesn't really matter. And of course, burn damage finishes off Cresselia. So now I can send in my Yanmega, which is really kind of screwed over by the fact that Trick Room's up. And I can also send in my own Metagross, which should be able to deal with his Metagross and Hitmontop with relative ease for now. So he's going to Protect with Metagross, and I'm just going to go for the Earthquake with my own Metagross whilst using, I think, Detect with my Yanmega, just to make sure that Metagross or Hitmontop don't decide to try and have a crack at it just yet. So I go for the Earthquake, and it's going to do a fair amount. Hitmontop obviously got some damage off on my own Metagross, and now my speed boost activates, which means that Yanmega is now going to be slower than everyone else for definite. So Metagross actually goes for a Bullet Punch onto my Yanmega, which is kinda wrong, I guess. I guess he forgot about the fact that Trick Room was in place and Tailwind had ended, but either way, he didn't really do a great deal, which means that Earthquake from my side can finish off his two Pokemon, and we won't really have much of a problem. All he has left now is a Terrakion, which actually makes this kind of match rather interesting. Obviously, Trick Room's going to come back to normal now that it's been 5 turns, and I get Speed Boost, which means that my Yanmega is actually faster than his Terrakion at the moment. So he's going to go for a protect, just to kind of get the stall off, which means that my air slash and bullet punch from Metagross aren't going to do any damage to Tracheon this turn. So all I'm really going to do is get a speed boost from Yanmega and just do exactly the same next turn. So I go for the bullet punch, it's going to get a bit of damage off onto Tracheon, and hopefully, I was hoping, it was well within range to be KO'd by an air slash. But unfortunately, air slash actually misses. He then goes for a Sacred Sword, which leaves Metagross on 1 HP, which I didn't think he was going to do that. I thought he was going to use Close Combat, which would have meant that Metagross would have been gone, and I would, you know, it was close, put it that way. He's able to protect, obviously stall out a bit more, and then we just repeat. I go for a Bullet Punch, I think? Oh no, he goes for a Quick Attack, sorry. Finishes off my Metagross, and that means that I can go for a Air Slash, and to my surprise, that doesn't actually KO, which is really bad for me. So Speed Boost is going to go again, and that means all he can do is use Quick Attack to try and KO my Yanmega, and he doesn't manage to. My Yanmega only just survives, which means that I can use Air Slash, which means good game to me. So hope you enjoyed that match. Please do leave a rating, you know we love it when you like it, and do check out the rest of our videos. Also in the description there is a link to the RMT for this team, as it is retired, so do check that out.